Welcome back to The Road Show. This morning in The Buzz, are you the type of gossip and then feel bad about it? Well, new research says maybe it's not so bad. According to a new study at the University of California, gossip could actually have some benefits like reducing stress and discouraging bad behavior. In fact, the research indicates that gossiping can be therapeutic. Many people felt the urge to gossip in order to warn others about bad experiences they had. Once sharing the information, people often felt relieved. Overall, the findings suggest that people don't need to feel bad if they are revealing bad behavior of others. Okay.
Whoa, that's heated.
Hey, did you guys hear about this new study? It's talking about gossip.
Gossip, yeah.
Actually, be good for
it can
you.
Be no. good. You like gossip?
It depends. I like
There's
to,
a pause
I like to
there.
Spread facts.
Mm-hmm. Is that
That's
what
how
it
I'll
is?
Say it. I like to spread facts. Yeah. But no, I can see this, because if you keep something in, if you mm-hmm. keep a piece of information in, especially if it's, let's say it's about you, mm-hmm. and I feel like it could somehow affect
yep.
what's going to happen, then I might want to let her know. I might want to spread it and be like, you know, if it's for your own good.
Well, I think that's the difference. You know, I always think of gossiping as being behind someone's back.
Uh-huh.
You know, if someone had something to tell me, like, Mary, you know, you have something on your face, I wouldn't want them to gossip behind my back.
Right, you want them
everyone.
To tell you.
I would want them to tell me. Yeah. But so I've always thought of gossip as being kind of the sneaky bit.
Mm-hmm. Look, anybody who knows me knows I can't keep a secret. I'm just letting you know right now. So if you have a secret, don't tell me. I can't keep
good
a secret.
Good to know.
I like gossip. I like to hear gossip.
Mm-hmm.
Spreading gossip, well, it depends on what it is and how good yeah. the story is.
I like to be the one that it's getting spread to.
Yes.
I'm totally with yeah. you. I love gossip. I mm-hmm. really do. And I feel like that's my little morning chit-chat with our producer there. It's always, sure. you know, what's the latest celebrity gossip?
Mm-hmm.
We're
yeah.
always kind of are exchanging information and things like that. So, especially because it doesn't affect yeah. me. You know, what's Giselle doing or what's Heidi Klum
yeah, that
doing?
Yeah, that gossip's okay.
Yeah, yeah,
that's okay.
I'm okay with it.
Yeah. It just makes it tough when you're working with somebody and you know
yes.
something about them and you're, you know, or you know that people are behind their back. You know,
mm-hmm.
you know.
But on the other hand, when you know that little bit, that wonderful piece of knowledge about someone, and it's burning up inside of you, and you do have to tell somebody, and it does feel good, mm-hmm. I must admit. I mean, I'm not the one to say gossiping is really a nice thing to do, but it sure does feel good.
Mm-hmm.
There
yeah.
are some subjects, though, you know, going off
yes.
of what you said, that I try and maybe even just walk away from,
mm-hmm.
and just, I don't even want to know it,
yeah.
don't include
right.
me, I already
right.
see where it's going,
mm-hmm.
I just want to avoid it altogether, because I don't want to get stuck in that situation
yes.
now where it is festering up inside of you and you're
mm-hmm.
like, oh, I shouldn't have listened in on that.
Like when I hear, you know, like if somebody's cheating or something like that, that's the kind of gossip I'm like, ooh.
Yeah.
You know, one of those deals.
That can...
Yeah, that can backfire.
Major repercussions
yes, it can.
Going
yeah.
along.
Yeah, I wouldn't spread anything like that or any, like, you know, if I heard medical information
mm-hmm.
or something like that,
right.
I wouldn't spread that. But, you know, the harmless stuff.
Straight.
The harmless stuff is, you know, is fun.
It is fun.
It is fun.
And I agree with you about the celebrity stuff. I mean, all of us, that's half the stuff we want to talk
it
about
is.
This
right.
morning.
Yeah.
So, yeah, celebrity gossip is juicy.
And it's hard to avoid. Regardless of the gossip, I'm sure everyone does it. It's
right.
hard to avoid.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm wondering how certain people feel when they do maybe let some information go.
Yeah,
and
when,
I know.
Yeah, when you go on Facebook, that's the best thing about
Facebook. I was
going to
say, I know Facebook yeah. and Twitter, they're
mm-hmm.
always, you know, kind of spreading things around, and I'm sure we've accumulated lots of comments today,
yeah.
right, Mary?
Oh, yeah. Well, we're checking in with Lisa Berube Fontaine, who says, gossip isn't healthy. It breeds anger and hatred.
Come on, Lisa.
And you can weigh in, too, by voting on today's poll. How do you feel when you gossip? Great, it gets off my chest. Or bad, I feel worse afterwards. And here's what's going on in some other trending topics online today. People are weighing in on Steven Tyler's rendition of the national anthem. The rock star belted out the song a cappella, which means, of course, without instruments, but people are still trying to figure out if they liked it. The 63-year-old singer may want to count his lucky stars that he's judging rather than auditioning for Idol. Our first viral video for the day shows a 13-year-old handling an LP for the first time in her life. Her reaction is priceless, and boy does this video make me feel old.
This is huge. This is like 10 CDs in one. How many songs does it have on it?
That one probably has, I don't know, maybe about 10, 15 songs.
For the whole thing? This is huge.
Yeah, it's a slightly different era back then.
But wait, I don't think this would fit into a CD player. What do you do with it?
Our next video shows a group called Red Peak Banding. They did an experiment in New York. They chained a fully loaded bike to a post on a busy Soho street and then proceeded to take a photo of the bike every day for 365 days, watching it slowly vanish over time. The project is titled 365 Days in the Life of a Bike in New York City. And there you see it's gone. I'll be back at the end of the show with your poll results.